Okay, so I've charged my unit up here. Everything's running good. You want to listen for any leaks here, and I don't hear any here at the Schrader valves. Schrader valves are the most common place for refrigerant to leak from. 90%, maybe 85, somewhere in there, percent of the time that you have a refrigerant leak, it's going to be at your Schrader valves. So you always want to make sure that you put these Schrader valve caps back on. This is like a second gate to keep the refrigerant in the system. Refrigerant never runs out in a system unless you have a leak. It's not like a battery where it uses up the energy. It doesn't use up the refrigerant. You should not have to charge the unit in a perfect world. But anyway, if you do, it's because you have a leak somewhere in the system. And again, 85% of the time, you know, 80, 85, whatever, you know, I'm just making it clear that most of the time your leak is going to be from a Schrader valve. Second most common place is in the evaporator coil, because the conditions the evaporator runs, it's always moist. You know, if you got copper, metal, all the conditions that work for rust and developing a leak, you'll see a lot of rust a lot of times on the evaporator coil. Anyway, when I put these Schrader valve caps on, I just finger tighten them, and then just a hair, maybe a quarter turn tight with my pliers, with my Leatherman, just to tighten the caps on, make sure that second gate is in place to keep the refrigerant in the system.